Leslie with MTG Lion, and this time we're going to talk about proxies, and in specific, whether they're legal or illegal. And really, there's been an eternal debate on that. Even though there have been copyright laws and it's been made kind of clear, there's a lot of debate on why some are legal and why some aren't legal. So I guess I'm going to kind of explain to you how that works and like the legal and non-legal types. Which first we need to kind of talk about proxies and what they are, and what that is by definition is it's basically a replacement, substituted, replica, you know, anything from that. It could be created by someone, it could be printed out, it could be a photocopy, really anything from counterfeit to marked cards, playtest cards, things like that. And although, like I said, although the copyright laws have been made clear, it does cause a lot of confusion. It does cause a lot of issues. So, and rightfully so, you could see why. But so to kind of put it in layman's terms, the ways that proxies would be legal is first, it's only to substitute for a damaged, broken, worn out card that you already own. Secondly, you have to let the judge know at your tournament that you're in need of one. And the reason for this is because only judges can give out these proxies. Proxies are given at the tournaments. They're not to be taken. You cannot bring any in with you. That's not how proxies work. You can create your own proxies, but they can only be used for like kitchen top games. So that means it can only be for personal use. You cannot use them in tournaments and things like that. You can use playtest cards, written in marker, for your tabletop games. You can also, some local Magic players, local Magic events really won't bat an eye at stuff like that. It's more for like tournaments that they're very on top of you with things like that. I know illegal wise, you cannot sell, obviously. You can't sell your proxy because you aren't supposed to be able to do that in the first place. If someone's selling a proxy, unfortunately, they've taken it from a tournament in the first place. So that causes a lot of confusion there on really who's to blame. And also counterfeiting. You obviously cannot be a counterfeit. That's illegal. It goes against the copyright laws. Because as well as Wizard owns the rights to the artwork, they also own the rights to the mana symbols as well. So you have to make sure that you're not copying any of this artistically or even symbol-wise. I think that's about it. Usually it's a base-to-base when it comes to tournaments on whether or not they're going to have them or use them. But for the most part, yes, they just have to be sanctioned out. They have to be given out by the judge, which actually feels like it might be a little bit easier than trying to decide yourself, is this going to be legal or is this not going to be legal? But yeah, that's all I have for you guys right now. And give me your feedback and let's talk about it. And I can't wait to hear from you.